This is a hard video to make, a tough one. I don't even really believe that I have to say this. It's hard to accept, but apparently I don't know what I'm talking about when it comes to selling trading cards on eBay. Apparently, I've been giving out false information and misleading the masses. Oh no, I mean, why else would someone write this if that wasn't true? So this is just gonna be a short little baby video where I go over how much it actually costs to sell trading cards on eBay. I do want to give a quick shout out to the channel that comment came from. It's Cards to Cash, another channel of mine that goes more in depth into trading card sales online. Check it out if you like that stuff, or if you like hearing me talk, because there's a lot of that there. Let's just give this guy a read, though. Maybe I'm the wrong one. Maybe Sean Sweeney is right and I'm wrong. I will help you out, my friend. eBay fees are about 20% of your sales. The IRS gets 30% of your sales. Already wrong on both accounts. Shipping costs $4.50 to $21. Wrong. To 21, that's when it stops. Envelopes, 7 for 10. Tape, $4. So selling on eBay will cost you money. You can't use any media platform without the IRS getting its cut. Good talk, my friend. What a self-righteous, absolute moron. A nincompoop. An imbecile who is filled with undeserved confidence. Every single thing he said is wrong. Now, why do I get mad at this? Why do I care? Because not only is he besmirching me by implying that I don't know what I'm doing, but also this is just bad advice. Is he trying to sabotage people? I don't know, Sean Sweeney. Are you so worried that people are going to be on your online trading card turf that you have to lie about the basics? No, probably not. I think he is just empty in the head. Stupid. A dum-dum. Let's talk about how much it actually costs, though, okay? I will use this as a teaching moment, a learning experience. And we will see just how much it really costs. We're going to be talking about a Hayden Hurst card I sold 2 days ago for $6.67 plus 99 cent shipping. All of the cards we're talking about here are under $20 utilizing eBay standard envelope. And I have my notes here. I might look down a little bit. It's very detail oriented. And I think that's why people just make up stuff about it, because they'd rather just type how they feel than take 5 minutes to go to eBay and find the correct pages and talk about that stuff. So without further ado, what are all the fees that we're dealing with? One, the eBay final value fee. Two, an eBay processing fee for the payment, and then if you want to call shipping a fee, then that's a fee as well. There's also the cost of a few supplies. We're talking about tape, envelopes, top loaders, penny sleeves, and I even tossed in a half cent for ink for you sticklers out there. So this card I sold for $6.67 plus shipping with tax. The amount charged to the buyer was $8.20. My 12% final value fee is based off of that $8.20 sale. So I'm technically being charged for the amount the buyer pays in sales tax. That sucks. I don't agree with it. It's the way things are. When you do the math, 12% plus 30 cents is $1.28. $1.28 is 15.6% of the total sale. So that about 20%. Just wrong, wrong and stupid. As you go up higher, that 30 cents is gonna become a lower portion of your sale. Yeah, if you're selling cards for a dollar, you're paying 85 cents in fees and shipping. But to say about 20%, just like as a general rule of thumb for low value trading cards, is just wrong. What about the other incidental costs though? Envelopes, tape, whatever, all that stuff I talked about earlier. Envelopes, he says they're 7 for $10. Where are you buying envelopes where 7 envelopes cost $10? Are you on Mars? Are these space envelopes? Are these envelopes made of gold leaf? What's going on? You can go to a dollar store and buy 100 number 6 envelopes for $1.25. That's a penny and a quarter of a penny per envelope. You can buy them in larger quantities for cheaper than that. You can get them for about half a penny if you're buying in larger bulk quantities. And all these things I reference, I'll link below because there is a best way to buy them. Then we have tape, $4 for a roll of tape. First of all, envelopes are self-adhesive, and if you just put your envelope in your printer, you're not buying tape to put the label on top, but let's just say you are. Let's say you are doing that. A piece of paper costs half a cent. You can buy 6 rolls of tape from Amazon for about $2.75 a piece. These are 300-foot rolls. You're gonna use about a foot of tape if you're taping on your label. If. So that means you're gonna get about 300 uses per roll. That's about a penny in tape. We also have the top loader and the penny sleeve to make sure the card is shipped securely. That's gonna be about 10 cents if you're buying in bulk, a penny more if you're not, but we're gonna go off the bulk price because if you're selling cards on eBay, you wanna buy supplies in bulk. Add that all up, 12% off the final value, 30 cents for the processing fee, 10 cents for a top loader and a penny sleeve, and then 3 cents for the rest. I guess you're gonna use gas to go to the gas station too? Well, walk. Well, if you're that worried, walk, Sweeney. And that's it, folks. Hope this broke down in a concise way how much it actually costs to sell trading cards on eBay. I have more videos on the topic on my other channel. I linked below. Go follow there if you're curious, and I'll see you later.